Hello and welcome back, peeps. Today we're going to be installing OBS plugins literally as fast as possible for the two main types of OBS installs. Standard OBS installed to C drives and portable versions. Let's go. First, we need to find plugins. Go ahead and go to Google and type in OBS plugins. One of the first results should be the obsproject.com resources one. Go ahead and go there. On this page, you're going to see OBS Studio plugins and a few other things. We're going to go ahead and make sure that plugins is what's selected. Once we're on the plugins page, you can go to filters and filter this any way you'd like to. I'm going to go by downloads and descending so I can see the most downloaded plugins. We can now see a list of plugins underneath here, and today I'm going to go over the top two plugins that are typically used everywhere, which is Stream Effects and the Move Transition. So go ahead and open both of these up in a new tab. To download the Stream Effects plugin, go ahead and go to the downloads up in the upper right hand corner. Here we see the Stream Effects Alpha 3 testing pre-release. So let's scroll down for a second. We don't see anything else here. We need to find the latest release that isn't an alpha. Go ahead and come up here to releases, click the release, and now you can scroll down. You can get all of them. Find the one that says latest release, which in this case is the Stream Effects 10.1. Click that, scroll all the way down to the bottom, and now you'll see a StreamFXWindows.exe. Go ahead and download that. Once that's done, go over to the Move Transition tab. Now for the Move Transition, once again, we go up to the Downloads page, click Download, and here we'll see the Windows installer and just the Windows.zip. I'm going to download the Windows.zip to show you another way to install these. Once both of those are downloaded, let's go ahead and open up our File Explorer. Once you're inside of your File Explorer, go to wherever you downloaded those plugins at. Once there, let's go ahead and start installing the StreamFX plugin. Go ahead and double-click it. It's going to ask if you want to run this. This is okay to run. This is from a reputable publisher. If a pop-up happens, go ahead and hit Yes. Read the terms of service and license agreement if you'd like, and click install. Now your installer should have asked you where you would like to install that, and let's talk about where you need to install that to. Most standard OBS installs are actually done into the C drive, program files, and then all the way down here where it says OBS-Studio. This is where most of the plugins are going to need to be installed at. So if yours asked for a location to be installed at and it didn't auto-populate your C drive program files in an OBS-Studio folder, you might want to navigate to here so you can install it to that. Now let's say you have a portable version of OBS that isn't the standard install. First you're going to need a tool called InnoExtract, and I'll have a link down below for it. It's a very easy program. Once it's downloaded, all you have to do is take a .exe file, drag it onto the InnoExtract.exe, let go of the left click, and you now have a new folder called App. Double click App, and now you see Data and OBS Plugins. If you copy both of those, navigate to wherever your portable version of OBS is at. I have all of my versions of OBS right here. I can then go inside of one of these, like this blank OBS one, and I see Bin, Data, and OBS Plugins, and I can go ahead and paste everything that I copied from that App folder here. And that's how you install something like this to a portable version of OBS. What about the Move Transition one? Let's go ahead and extract this from the zip folder. Once that's extracted, go ahead and open up the new folder. And again, you're going to see Data and OBS-Plugins. Go ahead and copy both of those. Let's install this to the standard C drive one. Once again, you're going to go to your program files. You're going to scroll all the way down to wherever you find your OBS-Studio. Click into there, and again, see how you see Bin, Data, and OBS-Plugins? That's the same format that you see from the plugin here. So all you have to do is just paste those right in. Now, I already have this installed, so it's going to ask if I want to replace them, and yes, I do, actually, because I want the latest version of this. And boom, we're done, just like that. So whether you use the standard OBS install spot at the C drive, or if you use portable versions like I do, you can now install any type of plugin, whether it's an installer or a zip file, to either of those. So now get out there and find yourself a new plugin to install and have some fun with them. And as always, everybody, I will see you in the next one. Till then, take care, everybody. Love ya. Bye.